Hello, class 11. Hope you are enjoying all your online classes. In my previous videos, I have told you about the relationship between Leela and Siddha. I am doing the chapter Leela's Friend, and I'll just give you a brief recapitulation of what we have done, what is the story all about. What has happened, Mr. Shiva Shankar was in his veranda and he was brooding over the servant issue or the servant problem when a man named Siddha comes up and tells that he can do the job. Mr. Shiva Shankar, he feels confused and asks his wife for the what can be done with the fellow. So the wife says that he sounds he looks tidy though, but that Shiva Shankar had understood that he looks tidy, but he was a little confused whether to take him into work or not. So he asks his wife that what should be done, and the wife tells that he's the same sort of the guys that we had. So after this, the little girl, she came up and she pleaded her father to take this man into the work. After he came into the family, that is Siddha, there was an unbelievable bond that was created between Siddha and Leela. What was the bond? That was a bond of pure friendship. Okay. Siddha used to tell Leela various stories about gods, princesses. Without those, Leela did not want to sleep at night. Leela, on the other hand, used to role play of a teacher and used to teach Siddha with whatever she had, the catalogs, with the alphabets. She used to help out Siddha with the alphabets and all. Siddha told Leela that he knows the moon, and they used to play with the ball. And Leela every time was with Siddha. So whenever Siddha ran for errands, which means short journey for doing any work, Leela went along with him. So on one such day, when Siddha went to buy sugar, Leela went with him, and when she came back, her mother found that the golden chain around her was missing. She asked her, she couldn't answer. She asked Siddha, and he also couldn't answer anything. After that, Siddha vanished completely. Leela's father, Mr. Shiva Shankar, he complained to the police, and the police told him that Siddha is having a criminal record, and he was annoyed with the fact that Mr. Shiva Shankar did not consult the police people before recommending him into the business. So after this, in this affair, we see that both Mr. and Mrs. Shiva Shankar, they were sure that it was Siddha who had taken the golden chain. But for Leela, she valued her friendship more than anything. So to her, Siddha mattered. The friendship mattered, not the golden chain. So when the police brought in Siddha, and Leela was happy because Siddha was back, the police instructed her, do not go near him and all that. She didn't care, because to her, Siddha was back. They asked him questions again that where have you kept it, but Siddha denied, and he said that no, I have not taken it. Now I'll continue with this part. Why did you run away without telling us? Asked Leela's mother. There was no answer. If you have not taken it, then why did you run away? Leela's face became red. Oh, policeman, leave him alone. I want to play with him. So Leela's face was red because she was angry, because people were accusing her Siddha. So she said, please leave him alone. My dear child, said the police inspector, he's a thief. Let him be, Leela replied haughtily. Haughtily means proudly. So he's a thief, it doesn't really matter. What a devil you must be to steal a thing from such an innocent child, remarked the inspector. How could you steal a thing from such an innocent child? Even now, it is not too late. Return it. I will let you go, provided you promise not to do such a thing again. How can you take a thing from such a little and innocent child? If you take out the thing, I promise I will just let you go, and everything will be forgotten. Leela felt disgusted, which means irritated, with the whole business, and said, Leave him alone. He hasn't taken the chain. You are not at all reliable prosecution witness, my child, observed the inspector humorously. So Leela said, just leave him alone. He had not taken it. But at that time, the inspector said, my dear child, you are not the perfect witness or the perfect person that we should believe to. Okay, because you are not of that age that you can understand what's right and what's wrong. No, he hasn't taken it. She kept on telling, he hasn't taken it. Her father said, baby, if you don't behave, I will be angry with you. So the father said, please behave properly, otherwise I'm going to be angry with you. Half an hour later, the inspector said to the constable, take him to the station. I think I shall have to sit with him tonight. The constable took Siddha by the hand and turned to go. Leela ran behind them, crying, don't take him, leave him here, leave him here. She clung to Siddha's hand. He looked at her mutely like an animal. Mr. Shiva Shankar carried Leela back into the house. Leela was in tears. Okay. So what happened? The police people, they said that, take him. Okay, the inspector ordered, take him. I'm going to deal with him at night and I'm going to take out the truth from his stomach. Little Leela, she wept deeply. She cried because she knew that her Siddha was not a thief. Here, children, I can bring in relation to another prose piece. That is Kabuliwala by Rabindranath Tagore. Maybe the story is not of the same, it does not have the same storyline. But the bond that was shared between Mini and Kabuliwala, and here we see a bond between Siddha and Leela. Mini was a little child, Leela is a little child. Kabuliwala had a criminal record. And here also, Siddha also, he had a criminal record. When Kabuliwala was taken by the police, Mini cried, okay? Similar way when Siddha was taken, okay? Leela also wept and she was uncontrollable. So Mr. Shiva Shankar had to carry her back into the house. Leela was in tears. Every day when Mr. Shiva Shankar came home, he was asked by his wife, any news of the jewel? And by his daughter, where is Siddha? So can you understand the difference, children? Means on one hand, a grown-up mind, that is Mrs. Shiva Shankar, that is Leela's mother. She is so bothered about the wealth, okay, that she keeps on asking her husband, did you get the jewel? If anything, any news did you get? But little mind, little girl, innocent Leela, she keeps questioning about Siddha. Where is Siddha? So you see the difference. One is maturity, one is innocence. They still have him in the lockup. Though he is very stubborn and won't say anything about the jewel, said Mr. Shivashankar. He is very stubborn. Okay? Ziddi it means. Okay? And so he will not say anything about the jewel. Bah! What a rough fellow he must be, said the wife with a shiver. He is such a bad person. Oh, these fellows who have been in jail once or twice lose all fear. Nothing can make them confess. They go to jail very often. To them, jail is like their own house, so they hardly care. A few days later, putting her hand into the tamarind pot in the kitchen, Leela's mother picked up the chain. So when she put inside, she got up the chain. She took it into the tap, washed it, the coating of the tamarind on it. She took it, washed it. It was unmistakably Leela's chain. When it was shown to her, Leela said, give it here. I want to wear the chain. Give it here because I want to wear the chain. How did it get into the tamarind pot? She asked. How it went there? Mother asked. Somehow, see, she is a little girl. To her, what is gold and what is diamond, what is lead and what is silver? Hardly she knows. So she didn't at all care. She sings somehow it went. Did you put it in? Asked mother. Yes. So Leela had only put it in. When? Long ago the other day. I had put it long ago. Why didn't you say so before? I don't know. See, such a simple answer to that she gave. When father came home and was told, he said, the child must not have any chain hereafter. She should not be given any chain. She's a little child. She keeps the chain here and there and it gets lost. So she should not be given any chain. Didn't I tell you that I saw her carrying it in her hand once or twice? I told you she carried it. She must have dropped it into the pot sometime. She had only dropped it. And all this bother on account of her. What about Siddha? Asked mother. And what should we do about Siddha? Because he had not stolen. I will tell the inspector tomorrow. In any case, we wouldn't have kept a criminal like him in the house. So now, the entire thing, it had changed and you see, it's not changed. But the fact is that they don't realize that they have done such a mistake. And they should be sorry for it because they had blamed a person who was not the thief. Who at least have not stolen anything at the present time. Considering the fact, Mr. Shiva Shankar tells, I'll tell the inspector and in any which way we should not have kept him because he's already having a criminal record. So children, here ends the story, Leela's friend. I hope you liked the story because it's a very simple story. The bond between the little girl and Siddha is highlighted in the story. This is a very plain and simple story. Hope you have enjoyed the class. Thank you.